All right, time for our viewer outrage segment. As the Obama administration grapples with cutting the deficit, former Treasury Secretary Robert Rubin, along with Julian Robertson, is calling for a return of the estate tax. They argue that allowing it to lapse has cost the government billions of dollars in lost revenues this year. Is he right? Well, Sam says families and savers will suffer if we reinstate an estate tax with a very low exemption. Families help build these often modest estates. Why tax their efforts twice? Well, joining us now is Kate Obenshain from the Young America's Foundation and Simon Rosenberg from the New Democrat Network. Kate, welcome back. Gee whiz, gosh, Willie, should death be a taxable event, Kate?
Well, no, it shouldn't, unless you believe that we should tax hardworking Americans' income twice. From a philosophical standpoint, it is an outrage. It's also an economic outrage. If the Democrats reinstitute it right now, then that means 1.4 million new jobs are going to be killed, not to mention all of the capital that is going to be lost in the economy, because instead of spending money to grow their businesses and create new jobs, individuals, after they lose a loved one, are going to be paying this massive tax, and exempting people is this $3.5 million exemption or whatever it's going to be is ridiculous. Many small businesses that individuals work hard to grow are worth more than $3.5 million.
Simon, Kate's making some really good points there, but you disagree. Well, tell us why.
Well, I think that what we know today, and I think what everybody can agree on, is that this measures taken to get the economy back on track have been insufficient. I mean, that we are in a much better place today than we were a year and a half ago, but that the steps taken are, well, that's indisputable, by the way.
And so we're
in a much better place than we were a year and a half ago. And now the question is, what are we going to do going forward to create growth, have broad-based prosperity for all workers, to get the deficit under control? And I think reinstating the estate tax is a reasonable step as part of a broader strategy.
But Simon,
yeah,
you know,
yes,
in your heart that Kate is right, because all that income has already been taxed once. I mean, that's the thing that's so vexing about the estate tax, that these businesses, the guy creates a family business, or the lady creates a family business,
my father's a small business owner.
All right, mine too, by the way, and I myself have a little tiny business. But here's the point: you're already taxed. Any earnings, any profits are already taxed once. This is the part I've never understood. So the double tax issue, please address the double tax issue that you incur if estates are taxed.
Larry, I think what's important about this conversation is that right now, the reason we have a deficit is because in the Bush era, we dramatically reduced revenues through tax cuts and increased spending. And the way that we're going to address the deficit going forward is we're going to need more revenue and we're going to have to cut spending together. It's going to have to be both. And there's going to be a big debate about what is the best way to create more tax revenue that does the least harm.
This is double taxation. Larry said it.
I'm trying to answer. So I think that I agree with Bob Rubin and Julian Robertson, two of the most wealthy and successful businessmen of the last 50 years in the United States, that this is a reasonable tax to instate, and it will do the least amount of harm while generating productive revenue. I agree with that basic argument.
Kate, what's the revenue impact? Do you really make any money off this tax?
You make about, according to the CBO, you make about $8 billion a year from the real estate tax. That does not count what you lose. Over a 10-year period, the economy will be short $850 billion of capital. Capital that can be used for businesses. This is an incredibly short-sighted approach to put $8 billion back in the economy. That it's a $3.5 trillion economy right now. And you really think $8 billion of decreased incentive and increased taxes is going to do something to raise revenue? We don't have a revenue problem in this country. We have a spending problem in this country. When we have quadrupled the budget in 1 year, when we've spent more on stimulus than we have in 7 years of the Iraq War, we have a spending problem in this country, and you're not going to solve it by taxing dead people and putting additional burden on their families.
Realistically, Kate, aren't people just going to seek ways to get around this to a certain extent?
That is a major problem, because they do. The compliance costs of the estate tax are enormous, because instead of just paying the taxes, people spend their money that could be growing their businesses. They spend vast resources trying to avoid the taxes. Look, this is not going to impact jobs. John Kerry and his family. They will be fine. He will find ways to hide his resources. This is going to hit the small business owner, the farm, the family farm, the people who are just beginning to grow their resources and want to pass their estates on intact to their children. These are not the mega wealthy Warren Buffett.
Yeah, you know, Simon, just maybe this is a minor point, but look, I've had some of these billionaires who are giving their money away that come on the show. Yeah. You know, what they're doing is they set up a trust, right? And then they donate their whole estate to a charitable foundation. And therefore, Uncle Sam doesn't get a nickel. And in fact, they say they'd rather do that than give Uncle Sam their money. How do you react to that?
Well, I just wish Kate had as much passion in defending the wealthiest people in the United States as she would about trying to figure out why we've had 10 years of no wage and income growth.
I'm defending the family farm and small
businesses.
Kate,
let me finish. You talk forever, right? So let me finish.
I got something to say.
I just wish any of it was correct. That would be better.
It's all correct. CBO numbers, not mine.
Kate, if I can finish, please, is that the point is, thanks for interrupting, is that the point is that The real question is, how are we going to create long-term growth and get the deficit under control? It's amazing to me, listening to Republicans on the air defending increasing the budget deficit by defending the tax the taxes of the wealthiest people in the United States. And it's a strategy that we tried in the last decade, and it led to economic ruin for the United States.
Simon,
we need a new path. I think this is a reasonable step forward.
Simon,
and I think we're
going to
be having a vigorous debate about this in a few months.
Answer that question. Why do you want to destroy incentives?
But look, we have to have taxes in the United States. If the premise is that any tax is a bad tax and we shouldn't have any taxes whatsoever, that's a silly discussion. I think the question is going to be is, what are the smartest taxes that we can have that do the least harm to the economy and create the appropriate revenue to have a government the size that we want?
Right.
What
this
Bob Rubin and Julian Robertson say, may I finish, guys? You didn't interrupt Kate, right? Is that if what Bob Rubin and Julian Robertson said today is that they think this tax will do very little damage to the economy and help close, in a much-needed way, the budget deficit. It's why they're supporting it. It's why I'm supporting it. It's a smart move. Let's have the debate.
We have to leave it there. We must leave it there. Simon Rosenberg, you are terrific. Yep. Thank you very much. Kate Obenshain, you are terrific. Thank you for your contributions.